Whoa, I made a big mistake. We weren't even on screen yet. Oh, sorry, guys.
So we've been talking all the time.
We're not that beautiful.
No.
It's not my best day today. Oh, well, yeah. Sorry.
Let's make it a podcast.
It can only get better.
Let's make it a podcast today.
Well, we were talking for 12 minutes without being audible, I think. Here we are. Hello.
Visible or audible?
I don't know. Were we audible?
Can
you tell me if you could hear us? I don't think actually you could hear us, but
we'll start again.
Well, we will start again. We had our practice run today. Oh my God! Sorry about that. I was checking the stream, but now we are audible. I hope. Please tell me, because it's not my. God, we were 100 people waiting for us.
Okay.
Do we get a response? Or can they
hear us? In the chat, and they were all talking, and some people actually replying on what we were telling. So it was really funny.
So we were audible.
No. Okay, we weren't. But okay.
Let's start again.
Let's start again.
Good morning.
Let's keep it short now.
We will summarize everything because we had our practice run. Klaus, the amps today.
Yeah. DIY kits.
Yeah, DIY kits. We have the Hypex Nilai 500. We have the ICEpower 700 AS2, and we have the Eigentakt Eval 1. And the funny thing is, Eval 1 is the stereo kit, and Eval 2 is the mono kit, but probably you need two amps. So that's why it's Eval 2. Nilai is new, Eigentakt is pretty new. It's the latest generation, and the 700 AS2 is also pretty new. So it's three times next gen class D. And pricing is a little bit different. The Nilai and the Eigentakt are both around 1200 to 1500 euros. The ICEpower is a little bit cheaper, but it's also less complex inside, because I was just telling them, but you couldn't hear that. About the power supplies, the Hypex Nilai has its own new power supply. Eigentakt uses the Hypex SMPS 1200 in this kit. At least you can always put your own power supply inside. But the ICEpower is one big module. It has the power supply on board. And when I was building it, because there was no build guide yet, I was thinking, where is the power supply? But it's all on board.
Which is great, so they can keep the price lower.
Definitely, because the power supply is really expensive.
Yeah.
And you can see that in the pricing. If you if you want to buy an SMPS 1200, it's a lot of money for a power supply alone. But also with Class D, which is not digital, it's all about the power supply. So I'm curious what you think. I haven't heard all three of them yet, A to B. I just measured them, I checked them if they worked, and they have been on power for a couple of days now. Okay. The Hypex a little bit longer, but I don't think they need a lot of burn-in time. So that's all about the Class D amps.
So today we have three reference tracks we're going to listen to.
Yep.
We're going to start with the pass labs to get a baseline, and the three tracks are...
We have from David Gray, from the Skellig album Accumulate, which is a very nice intimate track. A lot of acoustical instruments, some electronics, deep bass electronics, and a lot of imaging. So that's about imaging and intimacy of the music. We have from the Dutch piano player U Beving a track called Hanging D, and which is very close mic'd, and it's all about speed. Because there's a repetition of the note D, that's why it's called Hanging
Separation.
D. And you will hear a lot about speed, but also about how music interferes and interacts with each other, the notes. So I'm curious about that, how it will sound. And from vinyl, we have Massive Attack from the Blue Line album Five Man Army, which is all about rhythm and bass. So I hope we cover all the aspects of what an amplifier should do or doesn't
do. Yeah, I think this. I heard
it's going to be fun.
Yeah. It's going to be fun, absolutely. Well, as a reference, we used reference system, of course, with the Pulse Labs X150.8, the XP12 preamp, our own computer for streaming with the Mutec clock, of course, I can't miss it anymore, and the Sonet Pasitea DA converter. Cabling is mostly Grim and Driade for the speakers. And we have our own power conditioning still in place. The Isotec Titan for the power amp, not for the Class D amps, because they do a lot different. You don't want to filter Class D per se.
Okay.
It will get slower in some ways. I'm not sure about the Titan, but I just don't filter it at all because it will alter the sound, and I want to hear the amp.
Yeah. Okay. It's got
pure in the wall.
All right.
Yeah, and of course the TAD speakers, the Evolution 2s on the discs again, Martijn.
Yeah.
The Blue Horizon discs. So
yeah.
No so different bass this time.
No.
Not
no,
a bad
no.
system at all.
No.
No, if, no, no. But I must admit, I do miss the Focus. No. I don't miss the Focus.
Okay.
No. I like the TADs better, but it had to be an upgrade, of course. But
yeah.
You know, the AAI pucks, they did some stuff really good with the bass.
Yeah.
I do like them. Yeah. And they're still under the Mutec, by the way. I got them away because my Mutec did a little bit, did some weird stuff. And I wanted to check if it's okay. And it should be okay now. But with the AAI pucks, you get more air.
Yeah.
It's super weird, but it's still, it just gets more. Which tracks do we start with? I think we should do one track on the pass.
Yes.
All right.
Then I think we should do David Gray, because that's nice Sunday morning music, and we can all
Mellow in. All right. You calibrated on 72 dB.
Yep.
Martijn has the decibel meter, because the input gain of all the amps are different, which is really annoying. But we have to change the volume because the Nilai is quite okay. It's quite basic. It's the same as the Pass, I think. But the Hypex is low gain. The Eigentakt is quite the same, and the the ICEpower is in between somewhere. It's annoying.
So let's start. We play David Gray Accumulates on the Pass Lab.
Yeah, you can start the track.
Well, it grips and it grins like a vortex. It gyrates and it whispers from the wind, knowingly insinuates chance of certain light-eyed thing, emphasizing your least likable traits, baby. Thank you. east of Mars. And our homes and down our streets, singing like some mythic creature.
Okay, yeah, one of the camera mics was still on.
Ah,
because okay. I had to restart the software. But yeah, you know, it's our reference system, and I hope maybe we can do 1 or 2 minutes.
Yep.
Of the reference song.
Yeah, let's then play Hanging D from You Bathing.
Yeah, it's I know. Sorry, people, but we had to get some gremlins out of the system. I restarted the software, and it switches on all the camera microphones automatically. It's, you know, and I missed one of them, so you could hear us indeed. And you are very sharp, because it wasn't as good as yours as we can deliver. So one more minute, because the bass is really nice in this track.
And I don't think they can hear that from home, but
depends on your headphones.
Very, very special.
Really nice bass in this one. Kay. So we'll do one more minute, so you can get a grip of what's possible, and then we'll switch to the Class D's.
Kay. All right.
Yeah, you do hear everything.
Well, it grips and it grins, cavorts and it gyrates, and it whispers from the wind, knowingly insinuates chances certain light on thing, emphasizing your least likable traits. Baby, it accumulates.
We spoiled you with the high quality streams. But I'm glad you mentioned it. It's fixed now. So we can go to the first class D amp, I think.
Yes.
After we hear it, I'll show some measurements.
Yep.
And I'm curious. Which one shall we start with?
Take a pick.
I'll pick Eigentakt. That's okay. The one I know.
Moet een mute doen van de. Oh.
Right. It's on. Yep. I think this one has the same amount of gain, but
okay, let's please check. I'll just.
We'll just go straight to ICEpower.
Eigentakt.
Thank you. Okay.
It's echt niet mijn scherpste dag. Here we go.
Well, it grips and it grins, it cavorts and it gyrates, and it whispers from the wind, knowingly insinuates. Chances certain, light on thing, emphasizing your least likable traits, baby. Loose the mask. mythic creature of great eater through the gates. You can have better suction, even wanton destruction. None of this at a very competitive race. Baby,
first track. After this we'll just go on to the second and third track in one take. But I'm curious because the comments are all over the place. Sorry,
I can imagine.
Yeah me too. It's really different.
It's very different,
but I think it's important to state that we compare it with the past laps now.
Yes,
for now.
And we shouldn't
because that's totally unfair on those three amps.
Yeah.
So we have to settle down first and just listen what we hear, but we have to keep everything in perspective.
Yeah, but there are a few things which are very just purely on the,
sure,
the characteristics of the amplifier, which are standing out to me. One of them is that the sound is very clean.
It's really clean. Mm-hmm.
It's unbelievable.
Yeah, I feel you can hear those little background noises even better than the past laps.
Yes.
That was crazy.
I agree. Some layering is just...
The layering is different.
It's better separated in a way.
Yeah. And the rhythmic drive and the pacing is spot on with this amplifier.
Not bad at all.
No, yeah.
That's really good. All. Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's why I really liked the Eigentakt when I first reviewed it. You don't hear an amp.
No.
You hear your system. It is more dry, though.
Yeah, yes. The highs are a little bit more pronounced.
Yep.
Just a little bit more sibilance. Some less weight in the mids, but that's still comparing with the past laps, so that's, I think...
No, the past laps is, I don't know, 9,000 euros or something.
Yeah, that's
totally
unfair. So we should
totally
compare
it. And I still think it's more musical... But it's 6, 7, 8 times the price, so it's not realistic.
You also have Class D amps in that price range as well, so that would be a different kind of comparison. Yeah. I found the sound a little bit more metallic, but that's also against the past. So, yeah, it does a lot of things quite well, I have to say.
Yeah, some say, why don't compare it? This is top of the range Class D, and the past is top of the range Class A or AB. Yeah, in a way, but these are the DIY.
Yeah, this isn't the class
kits. So
this isn't top of the class.
You can tune it make it even better than this.
Yeah, you can go further.
This is their baseline class D with, of course, the same amplifier modules, but you can do a lot with the power supply. And I think Hypex and ICEpower and Eigentakt, sorry, Purifi will agree with that. You can make it better. And NAD uses it in their C298 and in their M33 power amps, and they modified
the power supply. Way. Yeah.
And it makes it different, better, I think, than this.
But okay, we'll hear all three of them.
Yep. Yeah, let's get to the second and third track.
Yes. Thank you.
2.
Ja. Is toch 33 deze plaat?
Ja.
Ja, hij stond op 45. Ach.
Oh, de... Hij is nog niet klaar.
Come on. Yeah, go, 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 go. Klik.
Die is wat zachter, denk ik.
Ja,
dat denk ik wel.
This one place that we told. 4 technique plus 2 mixer board. Sharper than a Wilkerson razor sword.
When I was a child, I played some booty, yo. One. My table, then I graduate to studio. One. Cause these my nom de plume, you know, the three's my pseudonym. And around my neck, you know, I wear the Sony Budokan. Indigo blue sugar, me in my own shoes. The people dancing in the shade for what they made, they can't lose. Yes, wax and lyrical, the time is not satirical. It's kind of spherical, so
so whether you're black or white or half caste in your complexion.
Yes, pull out your phone or plug and tuck you in your phony. It started by Marconi, resumed by Sony. A summary and wireless, history and only. But massive attack and only, explosion.
Yeah.
Oh man, ja, die plaat is zo groot. Oh nee, ik moet wel blijven draaien. Dit gaat nog eindeloos door namelijk. Yeah. Alright. Yeah, that track goes on and on and on.
Yeah. And yeah. Money is the root of all evil, as you can hear in the song.
It is.
Well.
All right.
I'll switch the amps. You can do some comments.
Yeah.
Martijn.
Well, I knew that the U-Bavin track is a difficult one for amplifiers.
It's not, but, it's but not an easy one.
It's really how to kill an amplifier. Yeah. Well, I didn't expect this.
I didn't think it was bad, though.
No, it wasn't bad, but it's very difficult. There are a few things going on in the track which I heard distinctly, which was very funny to me. The trick of this whole piece is that if you have this repetitious note and he plays over with a lot of sustain on the piano, and he plays over the chords, there should be a new notes created from the harmonics,
mm-hmm.
and those were gone. Those were missing.
Were gone. Yeah, it was too clean.
It was too clean. Yeah.
Yeah.
So that was the one, and this amplifier, the Purifi, actually struggled with the midtones. So the first section that he plays the harmonics is in the high notes, then in the mid notes, and then in the bass on the end, rumbling sound. And in the mids, it really struggled. So that was a bit surprising to me.
I also felt that it lacked a little bit of drama.
Yeah.
There was less drama in the sound.
Yeah.
It didn't really move me,
no.
the piece. But yeah, okay. I found the amp to be fast enough.
Yes.
Yeah.
Clean enough. The notes linger, but there was something missing in the midst as well. Yeah.
Yep. So that was funny. And then Massive Attack from vinyl, which is completely different.
Yeah, it is.
That was
the speed and the pacing in the rap parts in the start. That was nice.
Yeah. I also liked it a lot with the Massive Attack track.
Yep.
I just found the sub bass just a little less controlled,
yeah.
Compared to the past laps, of course. Voices were a little more forward, which was kind of nice, actually. They popped out of the speakers. Everything sounded pretty smooth, because this recording on CD or a stream can get pretty hot easily. It's quite a lot of sibilance, tricky as singing very close to the mic. But this is quite a good recording on vinyl, I guess. Those drums, they zing nicely.
Yeah.
Not too much, Of course, with the TAD speakers, it's also very
smooth.
Yeah, smooth, and they bring a lot. I really liked it with Massive Attack.
Yeah, me too.
The amplifier brought it all out.
Yeah.
So.
Yeah. Yeah, voices were great. Flow was good again. Mids were clean and balanced. Yeah.
The only thing I found a bit lacking was the depth of the soundstage. The soundstage was a bit flat for me with the vinyl. I know it can be
maybe. Yeah.
It can be bigger.
Sure. Yeah.
Yeah. But don't forget, this is 12.
Yeah, I know.
50
I know.
Euros.
Yeah.
It's if we compare it to a power amp in that price range,
then it's very good.
And compare it to the NAD C298, which is a little better than this.
Or should be.
Well, I owned a pair, so I do know it's a little bit better than this.
Yeah, okay.
But it's not a huge leap. And you get a little bit of a nicer box and a little bit more depth and a little bit more smoothness, but you pay more.
Yeah.
So
I think it did pretty well.
I think it did pretty well considering the price.
Really,
and of
really
course,
well.
Yeah,
yeah.
You can do better.
You can always do better.
You can always do better.
Yeah.
And did anything change in the new year with your mic recording setup? No. It didn't. I just checked. It's all correct, and I calibrated it on Friday. So
can they hear us now? all three
of us? They can hear us perfectly well, but no, nothing changed in the setup actually. No. I did think it was fast and it had a lot of presence.
Yep.
I do think compared to the bass, the mids are a little bit rough. But yeah, that's compared to a high-end Class A amp.
I thought it would be worse.
Me too, actually.
It's not a really big gap or so.
No,
it's not that you go, it's not, wow, too,
it's not like, oh, crap.
No, absolutely not. It's really good. Yep. And it's really clean, and it's really detailed, and it's really fast. And I think it's amazing considering what Class D did 15 years ago.
Yeah.
Class D 15 years ago was just bad.
Yep.
And now it's really good. So kudos to the Purifi team. What are the artists? What is the artist and the title of the second song?
That's You Beving, a Dutch piano player, B E V I N G.
Yeah.
And the title is Hanging D.
Yeah. Like the track. It's it is indeed an amp killer.
It is a speaker killer. Yes.
It's really hard to get it
right. I'm not that big a fan of the track, but okay.
No, not in terms of music, but
it's good for testing. It's good for testing.
I like it as music as well. So
not my cup of tea.
I imagined it wouldn't. So
one of the most,
but it's quite a good one to test.
Yes.
One of the most misquoted. It's not money is the root of all evil. It's the love of money is the root of good evil.
Okay. Thank you for that.
Okay, I didn't know that, and I know Massive Attack pretty well. Are all amps already burned in?
Yep.
I do think so. The Nilai had a little bit more time, but the other ones came in on Wednesday, and they've been powered on ever since. Not all with signal, because I only have two power outputs on the pass, power amp outputs. But I swap them regularly, so we they should be okay. I don't think it's 100% yet, but close enough. Nilai, I'm really curious.
Yes.
All right.
Yeah. Here we go.
Switch to input one.
Oh yeah.
Well, it grips, and it grins, cavorting, it gyrates, and it whispers from the wind, knowingly, mindless needed from the high rise, staring back with your own eyes, playing games with the numbers, messing around with the dates, altering its position, muttering sweet propositions, doing its damnedest to get you between the shades. I'd start out kicking and screaming. Pretty soon you're gonna wind up sucking on the tapes. 'Cause baby, it accumulates. Baby,
I really want to start with this one.
All right.
Okay. I definitely like it more.
Yes.
Well, it's more relaxed.
It's different.
It's smoother sounding.
Thank you. That's exactly what I heard. It's more smooth.
Yeah.
And now I really liked the Eigentakt when I first reviewed it. I haven't heard this one, but I mean, mostly, at the most, one track. Mm-hmm. And I thought, okay, this is really good. But now I hear them A-B. For me, Nilai is definitely smoother, and I hear the guitar more. The strings are more like the guitar strings.
Yeah. And the guitar was very evident.
With the guitar, I heard it, and André Horstman, I think he's called. I'm sorry if I'm wrong. He said it. Yeah, André Horstman. He said the guitar is sounding better, and he's definitely right. The guitar is obviously better than with the Eigentakt.
The older sounds also. I noticed it with the cello. It's more natural sounding.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
It is. And it blends more. All the sounds blend more.
Yes.
These. What I wrote down was that compared to Purifi, it's less of listening through a looking glass. With Purifi, I have the feeling it's. With a looking glass on the music, and this is more backwards, but it
more
blends
relaxed.
Better. Yes,
I 100% agree. Mm-hmm. That's what I said to Jeffrey. I said with Eigentakt, really into your face, and it's really detailed, and it's really there.
Yeah.
But it's not relaxed.
For me, I needed a little more time to adjust.
Yeah,
I can't adjust as quickly as you guys can. It's true.
Philip Morris said even better than the past in some ways. Well, I don't know.
That's a bold statement.
It is impressively good.
It's the naturalness and the smoothness of the tonality of the music is really, really, really good with this one.
Yeah.
That's outstanding. So I'm very curious about the next track.
Yeah.
Yeah.
How that will sound. But
I did think, by the way, sorry to interrupt, but I did think the bass was a little bit less.
Yes.
Yeah, less impact in the bass.
Yes, but it was more balanced.
But that doesn't have to be a bad thing.
No.
No.
But
no,
it's not just bad.
It's rhythmically, it was a lot slower than the Purifi.
Yeah.
It's a different flow.
It's a different flow.
I don't know.
Yeah,
it's I'm not sure yet.
It's slower.
I don't know. I didn't even show the measurements, but we'll get to that later. Yeah, it's not really important. Maybe in the end.
We need a second track.
Yeah,
we need a second track. Yeah.
We do.
The piano. Okay. Yeah, cool. I like it.
I'm impressed.
I'm impressed. Yes, me too. I'm actually a little bit speechless. It's really good.
Yeah.
Let's get to the second track. Thank you.
vergeten we hem niet. Jung is on the chat.
Bro. Hey, Jung.
He thought it was a very nice track. And I know you hear me on the left, I think, right now. Should be stereo, should be obvious I'm right here.
Yeah. Jung, don't look, please.
really, so it's the last track, isn't it?
Yeah.
Okay. I'm doing my best, Jung. Doing the best I can. Okay. Oh. Yeah. Twee moet ie.
Sorry.
But we're playing vinyl, Jung.
Especially for you.
Chance drive, people say out loud. Why should I hide? Only had a small taste, so what a waste. I quietly observe there is not much space. Bottom ends heavy, you know we're never even. People call me tricky for a particular reason. I got you saying, and I got to let you know. Same rocking in your area, rock beneath your balcony. My baby just cares for me, why that's funny. Her touch tickles, especially on my tummy.
Who's got the mic?
Now who's honey?
It's Robo Turbo and Chung to a charge. I did a DGY bunch crew and large. Don't call me an officer, just call me a sarge. Mashing up the country town and also abroad. Plan to go to America when I get a visa card.
But getting a visa card nowadays isn't hard.
So keep your ears peeled, I listen to every card. Tokyo City's one place that we told. 4 Tiffany plus 2 mixable. Sharper than a Wilkerson razor sword.
When I was a child, I played some Studio One. My table, then I graduate to Studio One. Cause these my nom de plume, you know, the three's my pseudonym. And around my neck, you know, I wear the Sony Rubicon. Indigo blue sugar, made in my own shoes. The people dancing in the shade for what they made, they can't lose. Yes, waxing lyrical, the time is not satirical. It's kind of spherical, so jam me in a cyrical. This is the miracle, I'm end up in the selection.
So whether you're black or white or half cast in your complexion.
Yes, pull out your phone or plug and tuck you in your phony. It started by my coney, resumed by Sony. A summary of wireless history and only. By massive attacking only.
I do the best I can.
No problem.
Yep. There we go. Let me switch the mics.
Yeah, we're back.
Well,
that was interesting.
That was
different.
There was flow in the music.
Mm-hmm.
So
yeah,
I mean, with the first amplifier, with the Purifi, the rep was very much on point and very pointy, and here
pointy,
it was flowing.
It's
almost unbelievable. It's the same record.
Yeah,
it's more relaxed.
Yes.
So for me, there was just a little less sub bass, but that brought everything together. And maybe it was too much in the previous amp, I don't know. It's more relaxed. The voices are just a little bit more in the back. The previous amp, it was more forward.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
The rhythm of the drums and the bass click together in this.
Yep.
With the
everything
not
clicks together. I said it was scary close to the pulse labs.
Hmm.
It's different, and I still think the pulse has more mid-range glow, but this is
more control as well.
Scary close to the pulse.
There's a lot of coherence in the sound stage.
Yeah.
And there's reverb, and you hear in the end there's that effect with the echo, and it was very deep, the echo. I'm a bit with Hanging D from You Bathing.
Yeah.
I was like,
Well,
what should happen happened. So when he plays the chords, there are notes appearing from the interaction between the D, a repeating D, and the chords he lays down, and those were audible this time.
Yeah.
But more importantly, there's a kind of urgency in the music, like
he's involved.
Yeah. There's a. Always when I hear this track, it's very different from the other tracks on this album. There's a kind of like he's exercising some ghosts or something like that, you know, and you feel it here. That was nice.
How's the soundstage?
The soundstage, I think, well with the piano,
so it's more in the back. I think.
The whole soundstage is more backwards than with the Purifi.
Okay.
In its entirety, it's a little smaller. I think it's more in the middle and less spread out. But it's
more intimate.
It clicks together. It's correct. Also,
so it's still a little bit smaller than a very nice Class A amp, but not really around.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I that can be. I don't know. It's hard to say because that's 9,000. That's I don't know.
Yeah, but some say I don't know. It's better or it's worse. But I think this one flows, and for a Class D, that's quite unique.
Yes,
and everyone is looking for something else. So for some, the sound stage is very important. For others,
I agree,
it's not that important. But I can agree with you on the feeling with the second track.
Yeah.
I felt it more.
Yeah,
I believed
definitely.
It more.
Yeah,
yeah.
There was a piano.
Yeah,
it was a piano. So you really heard the piano. It was very natural.
I even heard the cabinet of the piano itself, the wood.
Yeah, it's an upstanding piano.
Oh,
And it's very closely mic'd to the.
That's what I heard actually.
Yes.
You
hear it.
That's impressive.
And
okay.
What I really liked about the Nilai is the tonality of everything.
Yeah.
It's so natural sounding. It's correct to my ears, and I like it. I like it a lot. I'm really I'm a bit baffled still. It's unbelievable.
It's unbelievable for 1,250 euros. It's just insane. This level of performance for that kind of money, it's ridiculous.
Yes.
They even have a preamp, and maybe if we have some time, I'm not sure that we can test the preamp. Let's first do the ICEpower.
ICEpower, now I'm curious.
Right now. Guys, we broke the 215 viewers.
Okay.
Cool.
Yeah, so 217 now. Great.
I think this is very interesting because this is a price. If you are a DIY person and you like to build it, and then you can have this quality and this choice also, because they are different, as you can hear.
Yeah.
They sound very different. So you can choose, you can build your own, and you get a great amplifier so far for your money. I'm duly impressed.
Yeah. No, this is not nCore technology. It's Nilai. It's the new version of Hypex. So this is not comparable. I know nCore pretty well. This is better. They did a lot on the design. Let's switch to the mics. Yeah.
Yep.
ICEpower 700 AS2.
Well, it grips and it grins like a vortex. It gyrates and it whispers from the wind, knowingly insinuates chance of setting light on things, emphasizing your least likable traits, baby. Baby, it accumulates.
His voice is definitely harsher.
Yes.
Echt. Mm. Tss, tss, tss. Mm. I did like some stuff. It does flow, I think.
Yeah.
Like the guitar, it flows, but it has less detail. The guitar strings seem nice, but if you compare it to Nilai, it's definitely less detailed.
Mm-hmm.
And for me, there is more. Yeah, it sounds less controlled. I don't know, just
there's a lot of emphasis on the high strings of the guitar.
Yeah.
And in his voice, so the upper range of his voice, yeah, is emphasized a lot. It's a very wide soundstage. It almost tears it apart, the soundstage. So the looking glass effect is back again. There's a lot of detail audible, yeah, in the,
but this time
in the layering.
I also believe him. It's still,
yeah,
it was in the track.
Yeah.
It wasn't perfect, and maybe the voice was a little harsher, but I have to get into the music and yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah,
I like the bass as well.
The bass was nice, but it was less deep for my feeling. Mm-hmm. But it was good.
But it was tighter.
Yeah.
I'm not sure.
Maybe. Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. But like I said, it did some stuff definitely correct.
And halfway when the track calms down, it was the first time that I noticed it really well. So like, oh yeah.
Yeah.
So
maybe
it's coincidence, but
yeah, you heard it for the third time, the track, so.
Yeah? Yeah,
you
start
hearing stuff that you didn't
but
before.
It really slowed down. I'm not sure.
I thought the cello was a bit lost compared to the other two ones, which I thought was a little bit surprising because it's very prominent, the sounds on the cello, because it's very,
it's crazy how different
everything
sounds. It's
it's
really crazy.
True, the cello was less prominent.
Yeah,
yeah,
it wasn't even there. Almost.
No, that's really weird. You're right. Yeah. Okay, well, that's our first impression. Let's
Do
the piano.
Yep.
And Massive Attack after that. Thank you. Massive Attack.
Nee, wacht, nu ben je aan het opstarten.
Ja, ik weet het. Ik had hem per ongeluk uitgezet. Klik. Last track. Yep. Oké. Okay. Wow, this is. Well, not bad.
Not bad.
Come on. Give me a break. Right.
I'm curious if there's something in the measurements visible with this one.
yeah.
Because I have the feeling there's a problem with in the frequency spectrum. There's some imbalance in the frequency response.
Well, there is.
It's high in the bass, and then it's very on the upper mids and highs. It's very pronounced, and there's something missing in the mid range.
Something off.
Yeah.
Well, you're absolutely right.
You didn't like it, yeah?
No, I really didn't like this one.
That was obvious.
It is so harsh in the vocals, and I'm really sensitive to the vocal area, like most people
Me
are.
Me too.
And I don't like and this one does exactly that. Well, I can show some measurements if I can switch to the right input, and then I'll just show the three of them. Okay, let me see if this works.
Yeah, maybe we should first.
Yeah, because with the U-Baving track, I just switched to the measurements. With the U-Baving track, there was a ringing effect in the D's, and that was far too harsh. So the repeating D's, because it's so closely mic'd, you hear a kind of, I call it a ringing or a halo sound, which is there. And here it became very harsh. But the other two didn't.
The second part was better on that track.
A little bit.
A little better. Yeah. But in the beginning, there was less impact, less weight. It was fast.
But this was the only one that's not linear.
Okay.
And you can see it on screen now, I think. Yeah, you can see it on screen now. The frequency response of this one isn't flat. That's because of its design. Every Class D amplifier needs a filter to filter out the carrier wave, the 500 kilohertz wave. The further you put the switching frequency, the easier the filter and the less impact it has on frequency response. This one is not linear, and it has a huge bump at 30-40 kilohertz. The problem is, you don't hear that, but these loudspeakers go to 60. So it's still being put in the tweeter, and the difference is 2 dBs. Now, that doesn't sound like a lot, but maybe this loudspeaker, it does produce the frequency, and you still get ringing in the tweeter that gets back in the frequency spectrum. So it could be audible in this case. The bass is pretty good.
It mixes in with the, I mean, even if we can hear the sound, but the frequencies are being produced and they mixes are. With the other stuff and interferes.
Yeah.
And that's what we hear, I think, in the... In the halo of the repeating D's in U-Baving.
Now there we do a measurement. It's called residue. It's what's being left in between the switches, and it should be like a sine wave. And this one isn't. It's pretty rough. The distortion is low, but not as low as the Hypex and the Purifi. But it's not bad actually. The distortion. This is. Total harmonic distortion versus frequency. Yeah, it's pretty good. It's for a Class D, it's okay. It's not high end, but this one isn't high end. This is also distortion. The noise floor, though, is a lot higher than the others. It's at least 20 decibels higher than the Nilai and the Purifi, which are pretty close to each other. I thought it was a measuring fault in my case. I couldn't believe it was this high for a Class D amp. It's not good. But the frequency, the noise spectrum is not good on this amp. Also, which is funny, what did you think of the detail? The low frequency, the low details in the music. Like small details.
With Massive Attack, I wrote down there's a lot of detail to be heard, but it falls apart. There's no synergy in the music.
It's all about the spectacle.
Yeah.
The funny thing is the when I do a power measurement, it inputs very small signals to the maximum power. Nilai and Hypex are both very good in still reproducing signals. And with very small distortion, even if the input is really small. This one isn't. It's at 6 or 7 percent distortion when the input is very small. So small details will drown in the rest of the music.
I don't have anything about details.
Yeah.
On this amp. I didn't.
It was funny to see that. With 4 ohms, it gets worse. This is noise. which is not really great, but the channel separation is really good on this amp, which is funny.
And the lows were also...
Yeah, it's not bad. This is the power supply noise. It's not great, but it's not really bad. Let's get to the other amps. Let's pick the Hypex Nilai. This is the power measurement, which is crazy. I just stopped the measurement because it will just go on and on, which is scary for my dummy loads and the measuring equipment could break. But it's only less than 1% distortion at its lowest input. So all the small details will still be there.
Okay.
And get reproduced. Noise floor is really low. As you can see, it's minus 130 around, and ICEpower was at minus 100. The small bump is always there because of the switch mode power supplies. You can see here it's a very small bump, but it's only 10 decibels, so it's not bad. Let's see. CNOT for all the ASR guys, signal noise and distortion is 95, 96, which is quite the same as the Eval 1 from Purifi. In my measurement, this is at 1 watt input. Most of them measure it at 4 or 5 watts, but it gets better the more power you put in. Channel separation is less than ICEpower. I don't get it. It's weird, but it is what I see on the measurement equipment. Okay. It's minus 102, and the ICEpower is minus 116, which is really good. So they do something very well there. Frequency response is just flat. It's up to 10, 20, 30, up to 30 kilohertz plus, and then it just gets round off with the filter. So there is no high frequency bump or anything weird. It just goes straight to 30 kilohertz and then it rounds down. And that's exactly what Eigentakt does as well. Intermodulation is crazy good, damping for all the people with really hard loudspeakers, no problem at all. Power is good, and the power supply output is very clean. They did something really good with the switch mode power supply. There's no noise at all being sent back to the grid, which is the case with most power supplies, switch modes. They are very dirty, but these are really, really clean.
Okay.
And I can actually see the switching frequency, which is around 500 kilohertz, is what they also say. The residue is very clean on this amp. It's almost not measurable. So also very good. 0.0016, which is just not there. Distortion, it seems like a high bump, but it's still 0.05%, so it's not even there. No distortion at all, not measurable, at least not really. And this is the whole frequency range up to 90 kilohertz. It's just crazy clean, the Nilai. Last one, and then we're ready, and I'll switch back to the normal cameras. Let's see, Eigentakt Eval 1. This is here. As you can see, it's pretty comparable. The Nilai is just a tiny, tiny bit cleaner in terms of noise. 93 and 97 dB CNOT for all the ASR guys that like those numbers. So they're a little bit off in between the channels. I don't think you can hear that. It's very close. All amps are very close in terms of left and right channel, which is not the case with most Class AB integrated amps, by the way. There are the differences, but not with Class D. They're very much the same. As you can see here, this is the 10 watt noise floor. There are a little bit more spikes there. And with the Nilai, it was gone. And with the Eigentakt, it's a little bit, little spikes. 97 dB channel separation. So the Nilai is better in terms of channel separation. And ICEpower is even a lot better. 20 dB better. I don't know if you can hear it. I mean, 97 decibels is really good. I mean, cassette tapes had 550 or something, and on vinyl it's 40 dB channel separation. So these are a lot better than most sources anyway. Intermodulation is also very good. power is really clean, a little bit less clean than the Nilai. It's slightly above 1% with very small signals, and I think that's more important than max power. Maximum power is not even that interesting. I'm interested in everything below 1 watt, because that's where you play music and that's where you have all those tiny details.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And Nilai is a little bit more clean there than Eigentakt. I don't think it audible. Explains the fluidity or the smoothness of an amp.
The
ease of the amp, but you can maybe some details will be more in place. Like you say, it's a big mess with all the small details.
Yep.
Maybe that's what it is. With 4 ohms, it's harder. For most Class Ds, actually. And this is the power supply. You can see a big spike here. And it wasn't there with the Nilai. So the power supply on the Nilai is better than on the Eigentakt. Which is odd. Because I thought they used the same, but I have to check my photos. Maybe they're not the same. Residue is cleaner on the Evo 1. So there's much more sine waves visible than even with Nilai. I don't know how to explain this, because Class D is mostly rough or it's really well filtered, but this has almost a sine wave. That's impressive. Distortion just like Nilai, and yeah, well, a little bit less ice power. Distortion on these amps is so low.
Mm-hmm.
It's just the way Class D is, I think. This one goes up a little bit more than the new Hypex. So yeah, these are the measurements.
All right.
Evo 1 and Nilai are pretty close. Ice power is really off in this case. Let me see if I can get back to the main input. Yeah, we're back. Okay.
So, concluding.
Yes.
You start.
I think that I was very much impressed with the Nilai. The fluidity of the amplifier, the sound it brought to the fluidity to the sound it brought to the amplifier, and the natural, the way, the natural sound of it, the tonality of the Nilai, that stood really out to me, because I thought that was really, really, really good for any amplifier. So, yeah, I'm looking forward to a lot of amplifiers being produced using Hypex Nilai.
Oh, there will be a lot, I think. Yeah, they have a huge OEM division, just like Purifi, by the way. So the naming scheme of the OEMs are a little bit different. I thought it was nCore X.
Mm-hmm.
But there will be a lot of amps built on these. The only thing I'm terrified of, I mean, this is like 1250 or 1500 mm-hmm. euros, including VAT. VAT.
I was gonna say that.
This is really good. Most amps that will be produced under other brands are just a small modification with the price times three. And I don't like that in our industry. I mean,
mm-hmm.
You can, of course, there are risks, but if you build an amp on this, you can build a beautiful system with a beautiful power supply and a beautiful casing. And of course, cabinets cost a lot of money. I was shocked by the price of a decent cabinet.
Mm-hmm.
They're really expensive. And a lot of people are willing to pay for that, including me. I want a nice piece of audio jewelry
mm-hmm.
in my living room. And I'm willing to pay for that. And I'm willing to pay for a decent power supply and all the risks they have to take as a brand. It just costs money to run a company. But please don't charge 4,000 euros for a slightly modified Hypex Nilai. That's what I'm afraid of in case of this, because it's really easy to build.
Mm-hmm.
And you can buy a decent power supply from a third-party supplier, and you can buy a decent cabinet from a third-party supplier. Just plug it in, build it, and say, you know what, I build a new amplifier. That's not how it works, actually. But that's just me.
I get what you're saying, yeah. But I'm sure not everyone will
will
be able to build it
no.
themselves. It can be a lot of fun if you know what you're doing. For me, it was great to hear that Class D has come such a long way.
Yeah.
Yeah.
That it's really nice. All three of them have good aspects. The Nilai is calmer, is more more involving. It's natural, but the other two did some good things as well.
If you, I think
Class D, it's not like
one second
something you're going to put away or look at. You don't like it anymore. It's really there now.
If you want to have a lot of detail of your in your music and you're looking for a lot of detail and a lot of bass, I mean, with the Purifi, you really get a very tight and good sounding bass.
And you have to remember that this system is already very detailed and already very clean and already completely balanced.
Yep.
So this is an amp, €1,200. You're not going to put it in a system like this.
No.
So you have to put everything into context. You have to think about your speakers when you're buying one of these three amps. It's very important.
Yeah,
but
I agree.
Yeah, switching that argument around, you can put a Nilai in this system.
Well,
that's exactly what I thought. The system is
yes.
Whoa.
But
good.
Can you?
Even the Nilai produces decent sound.
Wow.
In this system.
Yeah.
Yes, but can you do it with speakers?
No, if you
€1,000.
I think so.
How will that? Will you hear every aspect of that amp? Will you?
No.
Will you hear the differences between those three amps? I'm not sure.
Yeah, I think you will hear the difference between those three amps. Don't underestimate what you can get these days in terms of loudspeakers for €1,000.
Yeah, you can get a lot.
You can get a lot. That's one of the nice things. So if you build a system. And I think the difference in characteristics, like the flowiness of the and the natural sounding sound of the Nilai, or the detail and forward playing of the Purifi.
But if you have a speaker
that
doesn't have bass, you will have to look for a different amp. If
you
have a speaker that's rough already, then the Nilai may work better.
No,
I mean,
no, you're thinking the wrong way. If you have a speaker without bass, you should buy a new speaker. And not match the amp because the speaker has no bass. I think
of less bass or more bass, you always have to consider the speaker and the amp.
It's
a
match.
That's what I'm trying to say.
I agree. It should be compatible with each other.
I really like the lows on the first and the third.
No, go on. Good this fight. It's entertaining.
I really liked it. And sometimes it was too much with the TADs.
Yes.
So that's not good. It's not gonna happen.
I agree.
It's not gonna happen. The lows are very important. They're the bass.
The bass was less controlled.
Sometimes it was less controlled. Sometimes it was too much. Sometimes it was less.
Yeah.
It's you have to look for a balance in your system.
Yeah.
That's
why questions
things.
I have this loudspeaker. Which amp should I have?
That's impossible.
It's impossible
to
tell because it's what you like.
It's what you
room,
like.
It's the synergy. I like. Boss Labs, some people like Moon, like you. I think it's a better match with your loudspeaker as well. Some people like Name. Yesterday I heard
are there new
Name systems.
You heard it?
Yeah, it's crazy good,
okay.
By the way. But
and crazy expensive.
When
yeah, 7,000 per component.
For me, it's a long drive to get here. And when I get here and I hear the TADs, I always have to...
Adjust your ears.
Adjust my ears.
I can imagine.
When I came here and it was with the vocals, I didn't have to do that.
Is it that different?
It's really different for me in the lower regions.
Yep. Yeah, the bass is different.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So I have to. Yeah.
It's richer in the bass.
It's richer. It's more.
Yeah.
It's deeper.
But
and with some amps, I don't like it.
It has
to be controlled.
I'm not sure.
Or I'm not even gonna.
Yeah, I'm not sure if it's the amp, but I get what you mean. Because Friday I was building the setup for the live stream today, and I was just walking through the hallways, and the Evil One was playing, and it had so much bass, much more than the pass with certain tracks, and it was too much. I agree.
And the last time we also had it with the Driade cable.
Yep.
Oh yeah.
It was like, oh, whoa, 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 whoa. We have to check this and
But I still think it's not the loudspeaker per se.
It's everything.
It's the combination of certain. But in
can we get to a conclusion to the end of the stream?
Yeah, we should. Conclusion. For me, the Nilai is the best of the bunch. I think the Eigentakt is close, but it's not as smooth as the Nilai. And the ICEpower is just not up to par with these, but it's also cheaper. We should consider that.
Yeah.
It's around 700. So for a DIY sub 1000 euro amp, it's quite good.
Yes.
I would still not buy it though. No.
Okay.
No.
I like the Eigentakt.
Yep.
And the Nilai. The last one, there was something not quite right.
Yep.
I'm not sure why. But yeah, I had a lot of fun. I hope you guys had a lot of fun as well.
Yeah.
It was really interesting.
It was really interesting.
I'm really surprised. Yeah.
Yeah.
And you, Martijn?
I'm. For me, it's very clear. The Nilai is the one that I dig the most. I'm surprised by the differences.
Mm-hmm.
That took me by surprise. So that's nice. It's not just. Class D has gone a long way, but also the diversity in Class D has been growing as well.
Oh yeah. So
that's a good thing, I think.
Yeah. It has really matured, and like you said, this is absolute. I'm not sure. Yeah, you said that this is the future of amplification.
Yep.
And I'm. Yep. Quite sure that this generation is already crazy good.
Yep.
The next generation will be what? My laptop just reset. Doesn't matter. The next generation will be extremely good. Mm-hmm. I think
that's why we had so many viewers today.
Yep.
Everybody wants to
know where are we heading.
Where are we?
Yeah.
What's Class D doing? How does it sound? I think a lot of people are considering a Class D amplifier.
Yeah, and I can get that. I mean, like I said, I have to pay my own electricity bill here. And the pulse lips is just switched off when I'm not using it because it's 475 watts.
Yeah.
Yes.
And I'm not doing anything. And these, you can just power them on. Doesn't matter. If you're not playing music, it's... doesn't use any energy at all. It's
all right.
So coming to the conclusion, I hope you enjoyed this stream today. I hope you have a very good idea of what you can do with Class D, how far it has come. We certainly did enjoy it today, I think. Also, we found some new tracks to really, really test test amplifiers. Mm-hmm. So that was also very surprising to me a little bit. Vinyl again. It sounded crazy good. This Massive Attack. I mean, I know that album. I've grown up with it.
Yeah.
And it's great on vinyl.
Yes.
It really, really is.
This master is crazy.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's a good recording.
And
it's
he didn't play it, right? So there are no ticks or pops or anything.
It's brand new.
Yeah, it's brand new. Wow. Yeah. I really like it.
All right.
Okay.
Thank you very much for listening.
Yeah. My laptop is broken, I think. See you later. I'll switch it off right over there.
Bye bye.
And
thank you.
See you later. Bye bye.
Bye bye.